Good morning all of you. Today's class we are going to discuss about some of the objective questions from the chapter Reproductive Health. So first question, medical termination of pregnancy is considered safe up to how many weeks of pregnancy? Medical termination of pregnancy, MTP, is considered safe up to how many weeks of pregnancy? So earlier we discussed regarding about MTP. So MTP is safe within how many months? Within 3 months, that is in first trimester. So go through the options: 18 weeks, 8 weeks, 6 weeks, 12 weeks. So 3 months means how many weeks? That is 12 weeks. Within first trimester, the MTP is safe, and after trimester, the MTP is risk. Medical termination of pregnancy is considered safe up to how many weeks of pregnancy? That is 12 weeks of pregnancy or in first trimester. Okay, next question. Which one of the following is most widely accepted method of contraception in India as at present? So we discussed earlier, we discussed different types of contraceptive methods. So in that, which one is most widely accepted method of contraception in India, in our country? Which of the following is the most widely accepted method of contraception in India as at present? So go through the options: diaphragms, cervical caps, IUDs, intrauterine devices, and fourth option, tubectomy. Diaphragms, cervical caps, IUDs, and tubectomy. The most ideal, most accepted contraceptive methods are what? Earlier we discussed. Those are IUDs, intrauterine devices. Question number third. Copper ions released from copper releasing intrauterine devices. Cu, copper ions released from copper releasing IUDs. So what is the effects of copper IUDs? Go through the options: suppress the sperm motility, make uterus unsuitable for implantation, prevent ovulation, and increase phagocytosis of sperms. So copper ions, what is the function of copper releasing IUDs? So earlier we discussed IUDs are three types. What are they? Non-medicated IUDs, copper releasing IUDs, and hormonal IUDs. So what is the function of, what are the examples of copper releasing IUDs? Copper T, copper 7. So what is the function of copper releasing IUDs? Copper releasing IUDs suppresses sperm motility. The sperm motility is decreases by the usage of copper releasing IUDs. Right? Option number one. Next one. What is the figure given below showing in a particular? What is the figure given below showing in a particular? Ovarian cancer, uterine cancer, tubectomy, and vasectomy. So this figure shows what? So what is this diagram? Female reproductive system. So female reproductive system diagram, and whenever the fallopian tubes are cut and tied. So this is tubectomy or vasectomy? This is the process of tubectomy. So what is tubectomy? The sterilization technique in females, the surgical methods in the females is called tubectomy, right? So this is one of the sterilization technique, surgical method in the females. So diagram shows tubectomy. So answer is tubectomy, right? Okay, next one. Question number five. Progestinoset and LNG20 are, progestinoset and LNG20 are, what are that? Both are implants, copper releasing IUDs, non-medicated IUDs, hormone releasing IUDs. We discussed examples of different types of the IUDs. So progestinoset and LNG20 are what type of IUDs? Hormone releasing IUDs. These are examples for hormone releasing IUDs. Once again, revise regarding about IUDs. Progesterone and LNT20. Both are type of hormone releasing IUDs. Right. Next one. What is the expansion for MTP? What is the expansion for MTP? So what is the abbreviation for MTP? Medical termination of pregnancy. Medical termination of pregnancy. Go through the options. Medical termination of postulation. Mechanical transfer of pollen. Medical termination of pregnancy and maternally transmitted pathogen. So what is answer? Medical termination of pregnancy, MTP, are also called induced abortion. Right. Question number 7. Which part of the female reproductive system remains blocked after tubectomy? Which part of the female reproductive system remains blocked after tubectomy? Fallopian tube, ovary, cervix and uterine cavity. So in the tubectomy, which part of the female reproductive system is going to be blocked? So cut and tied of what? Fallopian tube, ovary, cervix, uterine cavity. So what is answer? Yes, fallopian tube is going to be blocked because of there is no sperm entry up to the region of ova. There is no fertilization. Alright, fallopian tube is the answer. Question number 8. Which of the following is not a copper releasing IUD? Some of the IUDs are given. Which of the following is not a copper releasing IUDs? LNG20, copper T, Lippos loop, and A and C. Answer. So, which of the following is not a copper releasing IUD? LNG20 is what type of IUD? Hormonal IUD. Copper T is the copper releasing IUD. Lippos loop water, non-medicated IUDs. So both A and C. So hormonal IUD and non-medicated IUDs. These both are not a copper releasing IUDs. Only copper T, only copper releasing IUDs. So what is answer? Both A and C are not a copper releasing IUDs. LNG20 is hormonal IUD and Lippos loop is non-medicated IUDs. Right. Next question. Question number 9. Natural contraceptive methods works based on which principle? The natural contraceptive methods works based on which principle? Earlier we discussed there is 3 different types of natural contraceptive methods. What are they? Lactation and amenorrhea, coitus interrupts, So earlier we discussed regarding about 3 different types of natural contraceptive methods. So what are they? Lactational amenorrhea and coitus interrupts and rhythm method, periodic abstinence. So those are works based on which principle? The natural contraceptive methods works based on which principle? Preventing fertilization, preventing implantation and preventing ovulation and preventing embryo development. Preventing fertilization, preventing implantation, preventing ovulation and preventing embryo development by the natural contraceptive method. So what is not takes place? Fertilization is not takes place. It prevents the fertilization. Right? So whenever fertilization is not there, obviously there is no pregnancy, confirmation of pregnancy. Right? Next question. Most of the contraceptive pills contains. We discussed there is different types of contraceptive pills, OCP. So these are contains. The most of the contraceptive pills contains what combinations? FSH and estrogen, LH and progesterone, estrogen and progesterone, FSH and LH. FSH and estrogen, LH and progesterone, estrogen and progesterone and FSH and LH. So what is answer? So contraceptive pills consist with 2 different types of the contraceptive pills. Some of the pills consist with only progesterone. Some of the pills consist with a combination of the hormones, both estrogen and progesterone.